born in Bethlehem, raised a Nazarene, started his earthly ministry in Galilee, stood for the truth no matter the price, even if it meant picking fights with Pharisees, led to the wilderness where he was tempted by Satan using the famous three, the same areas where Adam and Eve fell. Fortunately, Jesus Christ succeeds. The lust of the eyes, flesh, pride of life, culminate to form the bigger picture, how Jesus Christ refuted it all by using the basic truths of Scripture. Satan flees, but it's only temporal, for the sake of prophecy to be fulfilled. In Genesis 3:15, where the serpent is said to return to bruise the heel. But we'll cover that topic later. Meanwhile, Jesus Christ displays his favor by recruiting the 12 disciples, including Judas, who betrays the Savior, healing and teaching, curing Israel's sicknesses and diseases. The Sanhedrin is now jealous, so now they're plotting for ways to seize him. So they hold an illegal trial by night, but they can't convict him without a reason, so they send false witnesses to accuse him of blaspheming, trying to seal our Lord's fate, but he's already got a leg up because they're in the present. This was handled hundreds of years ago in Isaiah. So as I continue to read the story, Christ is standing before Pilate, whose decision is being influenced by the noises of the riot, screaming, "Crucify him!" Our Lord is standing there silent, innocent in his case, but yet he's chosen not to fight it. Because in the garden when he prayed, "For this cup to pass away, let not my will but yours be done, stack their sins upon my plate." This is the attitude that he had when he was standing in Pilate's face. So when asked if he was a king, he can look him directly in the face and say, "My kingdom is not of this world." Making it clear that he is a king, and if his soldiers were deployed, well, that would be a different scene. But he had chosen to be victorious through his strategy to intervene, taking our place on the cross, knowing the type of pain it'll bring. Buried and resurrected, just like the prophecies projected. The sign of Jonah was now fulfilled before the Pharisees who had rejected, whose hearts were still hardened, so much that when they saw the tomb was open, they went to the guards and tried to bribe him to say his body had been stolen. But he'd already showed himself to over 500 people, where they showed him both the holes in his hands and in the side exactly where they poked him. Days later, he ascended, living a life that's purely clean, changing the status of those who believe from being sinners to now redeemed.